chosen bearer of the lamp. Like you, I serve. Until her embrace.
The tablets are all here. Just one more left, human.
Traveler, there is often no greater misjudgment than power being placed in the hands of one unfit for it. And Galinda's calloused hands and heart will only bring misery with the power of the runes. The final tablet. Bring it to me, and I...
No funny ideas, you treacherous dog. Remember, as long as you're wearing those manacles, if I die, you die. Galinda's already learning so much. She'll see those idiots back in Sturlevo chop on their words.
Another like you roams more instead, traveler. A man I encountered long ago. One already burdened then. A burden which has only increased enormously in the years since. And taken a heavy toll. And prolonged exposure to that obscure force so baneful to humanity. And his is a bleak, ruinous road.
Enough chit-chat. There's work to be done. The final tablet. Give it to Galinda.
With that tablet, Galinda will have no further use for me. But in my possession, it will allow me to finally cast off these shackles. All I ask for, traveler, is my freedom.
You shut your mouth. Don't do anything foolish, human. Not when we're both so close to getting what we want. Just think of the power Galinda can give you. Yes! Galinda can already hear its sweet secrets whispering to her.
A predictable choice, traveler. Perhaps I was foolish to expect another.
Now, don't be sour, Sparky. All that wonderful runic knowledge you so selfishly kept locked up in that big head of yours can now be put to use by someone who recognizes its value. Work like this takes time, human. But Galinda will have a little something for you soon enough. Ah, you again. Gerlinde's little helper returns. Sparky? Gerlinde's back to working alone and sharper at her crafts than ever. Also, that stubborn sad sack did come in useful one last time. Here. Gerlinde will be moving on soon, back to the Sturlevo Commonwealth. Full of squabbling, short-sighted half-wits it may be, but with her new runesmithing expertise, Gerlinde has some scores to settle. Spend or be on your way. Gerlinde has no more use for you. Spend or... Ah, you again. You again.
Thank you. Thank you. now.
Yeah.
Thank you. Get this damn thing, and who doesn't appreciate it? Damn, and who doesn't appreciate having?
Our holy work continues, Lamp-bearer.
Fellow sanctified vessel, may Aureus' divine radiance flow through me and into you.
Thank you. Yeah. If you're keeping an eye out for the pendant, then don't trouble yourself. I've got it back. Found the little monster myself, skulking in the dark with a horde of stolen trinkets. Dashed its brains out before it even knew I was there. It'll not be doing any more pilfering. To think, I almost lost my love's pendant. I never should have let it out at my sight in the first place. I'll not make that mistake again. And the blood'll wash off easy enough. I've been thinking. Maybe this was a sign from Katrin. A warning to never falter in the task I've set myself. Or to think beyond the only thing that matters. Honoring her memory. And tending to the vestiges. You be on your way, Lampbearer. Don't worry about me. Until the day I can finally be with my love again. This is where I belong. You be on your way till the day. This is where I.
This abbey once belonged to Mornstead's previous dominant religion before Judge Cleric declared it the Hallowed Sentinel's new home and sanctified it. To take a mundane thing and transform it into something magnificent and holy is miraculous indeed. I may not be wise, but one thing I have learned is that you never really know what life's going to throw at you. So, I hope you'll consider this friendly advice, not me thinking of my own profit. If there's anything amongst my merchandise that you've had your eye on, perhaps you should consider buying it now, just to be certain. Hello again, friend. Hello again, friend. May your path be blessed. Hello again, friend. May your path be blessed. Hello again, friend. May your path be blessed. Hello again, friend. I may not be wise, but one thing is that you never really know. So, let me think. If there's... perhaps you should consider...
As I willingly relinquish this token of my past life, so too do I relinquish my past entire. For I have been reborn in the light of our Eternal Lady and proven myself worthy of being counted amongst the ranks of her blessed servants, the Hallowed Sentinels. To her and our holy work do I commit my blood, my life, my future, and my soul. In radiance, judgment.
This tree grew from a seed into what you see now in a single day. One of Judge Cleric's miracles to edify her disciples. There once hung from it an ancient banner carried into battle long ago by Our Lady herself. A symbol of more virtuous times. And one torn down and disgraced since. Lampbearer, if you should find the pieces of the banner during your journey, bring them to me. I'll mend what's been broken, carry it with me into the heart of the Empyrean, and present it to Judge Cleric as a reminder of what the Hallowed Sentinels once were. I have too much Hallowed Sentinel blood at my hands to expect or deserve redemption. But I must do what I can for those who can still be saved. I prayed the banner had not been destroyed completely, and Our Lady heard me. It's a sign there is still hope. And I don't overlook your part in this, Lampbearer. Perhaps Pietar was right about you after all. If we can find the rest of the banner and make it whole again, its radiance will shine brighter still when I stand before Judge Cleric. If we can find the rest of the banner, its radiance will shine brighter still.
In radiance, judgment!